living in a $150 billion house with 3 toilets, 12 rooms, 6 sleeping compartments, and a lookout tower seems out of this world. In fact, it is out of this world. Over the past 2 decades, the International Space Station, which was launched into orbit in 1998, has been home to hundreds of astronauts. But how much longer will the space station be able to operate? Make sure you watch until the end of the video, because today we are about to look at what the International Space Station has in store for the future. And please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Futurephile, to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. In 1984, President Ronald Reagan approved the construction of Freedom, but due to budget restrictions, it was never completed. The vision ultimately evolved into the International Space Station, ISS, which is the product of the joint efforts of 5 different agencies representing 15 different nations. On November 20, 1998, the ISS was launched with a Russian control module, Zara, and the U.S.-built Unity connecting node, which was linked in orbit by U.S. Space Shuttle astronauts the following month. Dozens of launches over many years followed, each one putting the station together piece by piece, fitting tens of thousands of parts. The end result was a 109-meter-long structure, roughly equivalent to an American football field in length. Since then, the ISS has been continuously occupied with people conducting research and science experiments that have led to many inventions. The space station flies at an altitude of 248 miles above the Earth's surface. It circles the Earth every 90 minutes at a speed of around 17,500 miles per hour. The ISS is so close that the night sky observers who know when and where to look will see it without using a telescope from Earth. The station travels around the same time as it will take to fly from Earth to Moon and back in a single day. The ISS typically has crews of 3 to 6 people. However, the size of the crew has changed over time. After the Columbia Space Shuttle disaster in 2003, which grounded flights for many years, crews were as small as 2 people. The ISS has housed up to 13 people several times, but only for a few days during crew changeovers or space shuttle visits. The space shuttle fleet was retired in 2011, leaving Soyuz as the sole means of transporting people to the International Space Station. 3 astronauts traveled to the space station in Soyuz spacecraft and stayed for 6 months at a time. On the flip side, NASA chose not to develop its own infrastructure to get to the ISS instead of relying on commercial companies to transport its astronauts. NASA's Commercial Crew Program gave billion-dollar contracts to Boeing and SpaceX so they can develop their own spacecraft. Now, without a doubt, the ISS was extremely costly to design, build, and maintain. Every year, NASA invests between $3 billion and $4 billion to maintain and run the International Space Station, money that could be better spent on other programs. Its annual budget is about $19 billion, though the Trump administration has been steadily rising funding in recent years, with approximately $23 billion set aside in 2020. But with the help of SpaceX, ISS was soon about to cut off on some of its expenses. In 2020, SpaceX had won the race against Boeing when 2 astronauts were transported to the International Space Station aboard Dragon for the first time since 2011. In addition to transporting NASA astronauts to space, SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft can also transport commercial astronauts to Earth orbit, the International Space Station, or beyond. This is the first step in the agency's plan to establish a long-term presence on the Moon, with the ultimate objective of reaching Mars. NASA plans to send humans to Mars in the 2030s, but it must first accomplish all it needs to do here. Although the organization focuses on the Moon and away from the International Space Station, its partners tend to be doing the same. The European Space Agency is collaborating with China more closely than ever before. China plans to launch its own space station and European astronauts in 2022. While everyone's focus is diverted elsewhere, the International Space Station, ISS, is not getting any younger. The 20-year-old structure will reach the end of its useful life sometime in the next decade. Although the modules of the ISS were originally designed for a 15-year lifespan, the ISS is expected to operate until its 30th anniversary in 2028. NASA plans to end the program in 2028 to free up funds for more exciting deep space missions. However, once they decide to decommission the ISS, they will face the difficult task of removing the world's largest spacecraft from the sky. The space station will be pushed or pulled out of orbit back into the Earth's atmosphere, where the majority of it will burn up during re-entry. Preventing the development of even more space debris is becoming a higher priority in spacecraft end-of-life planning. Although some pieces of the ISS will survive and fall into an empty stretch of ocean in the South Pacific, the rest of it will burn up, break up, and vaporize into fragments. The debris is estimated to weigh between 53,500 and 173,000 pounds in total. Even when ISS is no longer with us, it will be remembered not only as the most costly man-made object ever constructed, but also as a stepping stone for more ambitious space missions. Without the significant discoveries made in the laboratories of the ISS, a new era of space travel would not have been possible. According to Bill Gerstenmaier, NASA's former Associate Administrator for Human Exploration and Operations, the ISS has a good operational life at least through 2028, and possibly a bit further beyond that. We just need to continue to watch the station, continue to maintain it. What we don't want to have happen is where we're spending more time doing maintenance than we are doing research. At that point, the utility of the station starts to diminish. Comment down below what you guys think about the retirement of ISS. Do you think the ISS will retire in 2028 or perhaps much later? If you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video that is shown in the end screen. See you there!